Hi, I'm Luke, bike gearhead here, and today we're going to be talking about something that isn't as common anymore, but still a lot of riders are riding them. We're going to talk about rim brakes. Rim brakes were kind of in the cycling world for, geez, I don't know exactly, but probably over a century. And they've kind of slowly been phased out in the last 5 years or so, specifically on road bikes for disc brakes. Rim brakes still have their benefits, mostly in terms of weight. They're still going to be lighter weight than a disc brake setup and simplicity. There's a few exceptions, but most of them are cable pulled. So they're very simple to work on. They're very easy to work on. And the purpose of today's video is to show you that. So we're going to walk through kind of some symptoms that you may be seeing that are a good indication that you probably need to adjust your rim brakes. And then we're going to walk through the physical adjustment of rim brakes and kind of break it down and make it as easy to understand. So a rim brake is basically just a caliper, which is what this black piece is here that sits on the frame. And it just, when you squeeze the brake lever, it clamps on the rim and generates friction and slows you down. There's a bunch of different designs. These particular ones are the Cane Creek EE brakes, which are a pretty high-end, super lightweight version, but the principles behind them are all the same. When you're out riding, there's a couple things that you might notice that are a good indication that you need to adjust your brakes. The first one is going to be noise. If you get any sort of squealing or kind of loud, high-pitched noises out of your rim brakes when you're out riding, it's a good indication you probably need to adjust them. Sometimes in wet weather, even a well-adjusted rim brake will make some noise, so take that into consideration. The other thing you might notice is you might notice some vibration or shuddering from the brakes, specifically from the front brake if you're braking hard. That's usually an indication that the brake is out of center and you need to correct that. Or if it's extremely out of center, you'll notice brake dragging. Sometimes I'm guilty of this. If I'm on a long climb and I just don't have the legs, I'll look back at my brakes to make sure that they're not dragging on the rim because it feels like there's no way I could be going that slow. But sometimes they will actually get knocked out of adjustment and you need a readjustment. So once you get to a point where you're ready to adjust your brakes, there's one thing that you want to do before you adjust your brakes that's really, really critical and can honestly solve probably 50% of issues before you even have to adjust. And that is to make sure that your wheel is centered in the dropouts. So what you want to do there is you want to loosen your quick release and just push up on your wheel and make sure that it's 100% centered and it's pushed up all the way in the dropouts and tighten it back down. Sometimes what'll happen is, if you hit a big pothole or something like that, it'll make that wheel be sitting cockeyed in the dropouts and you'll get rubbing on one side of your brake pad where the other side is wide open. So if you have a symptom like that where it kind of comes up out of nowhere, all of a sudden your brake is dragging, check this first because 9 times out of 10, all you have to do is loosen, recenter your wheel, tighten it down, and your brake will be working fine. If you go ahead and do that and you still notice issues, this is when we're gonna go through our adjustment steps. So the brake in almost all situations is gonna be mounted to the frame through a through bolt that sits right here. We'll go over the main kind of components on a rim brake. The first thing is gonna be your caliper mounting screw, which is right here. The next thing is going to be your cable tension adjuster, which is going to be right here. These are all going to look a little different, but basically they screw in and screw out a barrel to adjust cable tension. This is your cable pinch bolt. And then you have two of these. This is your brake pad mounting screw. And this is kind of eccentric, so it gives you some adjustment. And then there is a caliper centering screw, which is over here. Same thing on this one. There are different mechanisms for different brands. This is just what this particular one looks like. So the first thing you're going to do when you're checking the adjustment of your road brake calipers is you're going to check your mounting screw and make sure that it's tight. Sometimes these do loosen up. You don't want to go crazy on the torque on these. Just make sure that they're tight enough so that the caliper doesn't pivot on that point. So we'll go ahead and double check that. It's also a good time to do just a quick visual, look down the caliper itself and make sure it looks relatively centered over the wheel. And in this case, we're good. We're good there, so we just check that out. To do an adjustment, you're not really gonna touch your cable fixing bolt, but what we are going to do is just, again, check it, make sure it's tight. In this case, it's nice and tight. And then what you want to do is you want to squeeze your brake and you want to look at what's happening. So in this particular case, what I can see is that this pad, the left pad, or the non-drive pad, some people call it, is contacting the rim a little bit before this pad is contacting the rim. And that's going to cause squeal, that's going to cause vibration, because what's going to happen is as you're squeezing your brake, that pad is going to contact the rim, and the rim naturally is going to kind of try to spring away from that friction, and that's going to cause like a resonation. So in order to correct that, the easiest way to do it is to just adjust your caliper centering screw. So we'll go ahead and do this, just give it about a half a turn, and then we'll re-squeeze and double check. And now it's actually contacting this side. So we went a little too far, so we'll just go back a little bit. And now we can see that it's contacting nice and evenly. Once you're done with that, you're gonna wanna go ahead and check to make sure that your brake pads are centered on the rim braking surface. So I'm gonna go ahead and loosen this, and you'll see that these pads have quite a bit of adjustability in them. The easiest way to adjust them is to get them centered on the rim braking surface, and then just squeeze your brake lever. And what'll happen is it'll hold that pad in place, get it nice and aligned with that brake surface, and then you just go ahead and tighten it down. There's not really a listed torque on most of these, but a good way to make sure that you got it tight enough is after you've tightened it down, just grab that brake pad and try to move it. And if it doesn't move, you're in the clear. Sometimes what can happen if you're getting a lot of squealing and a lot of like kind of really awful noise is your brake pads need to be towed a little bit. And what that means is you want to get that front edge of the brake pad to contact the rim slightly before the rear edge does. The easiest way to do that, you just take a piece of paper, fold it over once or twice. If you have a business card, those tend to be about the perfect thickness for this. But if you don't, just fold over a piece of paper a couple times. All you're gonna do, loosen that. And then you kind of slide that piece of paper into the back edge of the brake pad. Squeeze your brake lever to kind of loosely hold it in place. Align that pad, squeeze it down so it's nice and tight and it's holding itself in place. And then just tighten that pinch bolt and release. And then you'll see that that front edge is gonna hit before the rear edge, which is exactly what you want if you have like a really bad squealing noise. We'll just go over our adjustment again, make sure we have even contact and the rim isn't being pushed in either direction, which it's not. And then the final thing that you can do is tune the brake lever feel. Some people like a very short pull, so to grab really easy, and some people like to have to pull like a lot before that brake pad engages. So all you need to do that is just loosen or tighten your cable tension. So now we're going tighter, so it's a shorter throw on the brake lever, and then we loosen to go with a longer throw. Pretty simple. One thing to note on these is if you do go too tight, what can happen is when you're really cranking or you're sprinting, there is going to be, you know, a certain amount of flex in the frame and in the wheel, and that wheel is going to kind of move back and forth, and you could potentially run into issues where your wheel is rubbing into your brake pads. So you don't want to go too tight on this adjustment. So just make sure that you've got it so it's where you'd like it to feel at the brake lever, but it's not too tight where it's going to be causing flex into your wheel. That's about it. Thanks for watching. Hope you learned a little something on rim brakes, how they work, how to adjust them, things like that. If you have any questions about anything, or you're looking to pick up a set of brake pads, feel free to reach out to our gearheads via chat call or email. This is an ongoing video series, so if there's a specific topic you want us to cover, feel free to drop a comment down below. Would also appreciate a like and subscribe to the channel so we can keep doing videos like this. Thanks again, and we'll see you on the next one.